I'm Sunny. I want to restore harmony for all pony kinds and make the world a better place. Today, we're going on an adventure together. Are you ready to have some fun?
One sunny afternoon in Maritime Bay, three Earth Ponies were playing a game of pretend. Young Sunny, Hitch, and Sprout imagined they were the main six ponies heading off on their latest magical adventure many, many moons ago in ancient Equestria. Once upon a time, there lived a very special unicorn named Twilight Sparkle. She was very bright.
As bright as the sun!
One day, the princess of Equestria summoned her to the castle for a very special assignment.
To learn about friendship!
And Twilight Sparkle made lots of friends.
Earth ponies, Pegasi, and unicorns!
Together, Twilight Sparkle and her friends, often called the Main Six, showed every pony the magic of friendship and how to live in harmony. The six ponies were two unicorns named Twilight Sparkle and Rarity. They had horns and could cast magic. Two Pegasi named Rainbow Dash and Fluttershy. They had wings and could fly. And two Earth ponies named Applejack and Pinkie Pie. Applejack was one of the best bakers and gardeners in Ponyville, while Pinkie Pie always hosted the greatest parties and had the ability to keep all the ponies laughing. Together, these six ponies had the power of friendship and magic. There was just one problem in this game of play pretend. Sunny's friends, Sprout and Hitch, didn't believe that Earth ponies were ever friends with unicorns or Pegasi.
The ponies are all supposed to get along, remember?
Sunny interrupted their game and explained the true story of the main six again. Except Hitch and Sprout still didn't think that three pony kinds ever got along. And they didn't want to play pretend as if they were friends. They thought it was boring. And they also thought Sunny was wrong.
It's like in the olden times when all three pony kinds were friends and they never used their magic against each other.
Sunny couldn't convince her friends. Sprout's mom believed that Pegasi and unicorns tried to eat the Earth ponies by zapping them with lasers and melting their brains. So that's what Sprout and Hitch believed, too.
They wouldn't do that! Those are lies! I'm going to tell my dad!
Sunny was so sad. No pony was on her side. Well, no pony except for her dad. When Sprout and Hitch went home, Sunny told her dad all about their game of play pretend. But Sunny's dad reassured her, "The important thing is that you always stand up for what you believe in." Sunny was so happy her dad believed that all three pony kinds used to be friends too.
I know Hitch and Sprout still don't believe me. But when I grow up, I'm going to show every pony that we're right, Dad. And someday, the both of us will meet unicorns or Pegasi, and we'll be best friends forever!
Later that night, Sunny and her dad made a paper lantern that they'd send to the sky.
Dad, I have an idea!
Sunny and her dad wrote a letter for all pony kinds that they'd put in with the lantern. Maybe it would reach the Pegasi, who lived far away in Zephyr Heights. Or maybe it would even reach Bridalwood, home to the unicorns. This is what it said.
Dear unicorns and Pegasi, you have friends in Maritime Bay. Come visit us.
Sunny and her dad released the lantern together. As it flew away from their lighthouse home, they wished that every pony would one day believe in the magic of friendship. After a bedtime story, Sunny's dad tucked her into bed and told her he had a surprise. He turned off the lights and placed a crystal ball on the mantel in her room. The crystal ball lit up like a nightlight and began to rotate and create patterns. Images of Earth Ponies, Pegasi, and Unicorns danced across her walls and ceiling.
It's beautiful!
Sunny hugged her dad and watched in wonder. He kissed her forehead and said good night to his little pony.
Good night, Daddy.
Years later, it's now present day, and Sunny wakes up to another beautiful morning in Maritime Bay. She quickly braids her hair and gets ready for her big day.
Perfect! What a great day! Let's go!
Today is the day she hopes to finally prove to the ponies of Maritime Bay that Earth Ponies, Pegasi, and Unicorns should be friends. There's a big presentation at the Canterlogic factory in town, where Sprout's mom is presenting the latest and greatest products that will supposedly keep Earth Ponies safe from Pegasi and Unicorns. But Sunny knows they don't need anything to keep them safe. All pony kinds were and can be friends again. When she heads downstairs, she pauses by a photo of her and her dad hanging on the wall. She wishes he were still here.
Today's the day, Dad. I actually have a plan this time. Wish me luck. Good morning, son. No time to chat, I gotta run. Cause I got places to be. So much to do. Excited, yes, and nervous too. A change is starting with me. About upsetting carts, hardened hearts, or wonder will I be lost? I've heard it enough, I'm calling their bluff. I'll never get lost in the gray. There's something inside, burns bigger than pride, shines out of me, lighting the way. Gonna be my day.
Be my day.
Gonna be my day.
Be my day.
Gonna be my day.
Gonna be my
day.
Ooh.
Hey there, hello. The friends I make, the friends I know. Today you answer my call.
Hello, anybody there?
Instead of hide, instead of staying stuck inside, instead of building your wall. Come on and party with me, join the band. Understand, we'll all be singing this song. I've heard it enough, I'm calling their bluff. I'll never get lost in the gray. Go big or go home. Gonna be my day.
Be my day.
Gonna be my day.
Ooh.
Everyone's afraid. Always judging, never budging. Ain't a time we make the team. The dream. Let's open our eyes. Sun's starting to rise. And finally able to say.
Gonna be my day.
Sunny leaves home and rollerblades through the town square, delivering orders from her smoothie truck and passing out unicorn and Pegasi stickers along the way. It isn't long before her friend Hitch, now the sheriff, stops her in her tracks.
Aha! There you are, Sunny. Just the pony I was expecting.
Morning, Sheriff Hitch. What's up?
Oh, please. Like you don't know? Today is the annual presentation at Canterlogic.
Hey, I'm headed there right now.
No, you're not. I know that you have come up with some harebrained scheme to sabotage it. And if you think I'm just gonna let you walk in there...
Look, you have nothing to worry about.
Sunny, we both know how this goes. Every year you try to sneak in, and every year I stop you.
But I...
I'm asking you as your friend, Sunny, not as the sheriff. Just please try not to pull any stunts today.
Okay. I'll try.
But as soon as Hitch is distracted, though, Sunny sets her plan in motion.